This video is a brief overview of the Axiom product, Microsoft Office Importer for Revit.
Getting your Excel spreadsheets or Word documents into your Revit files is not a good time. But sadly, it's required in just about every Revit project you do. Well, you don't need to be sad anymore. It so happens there's a little piece of magic that solves the Microsoft import puzzle. This magic will paste in your Word and Excel data with great formatting. It creates text and lines in a detail group. And it will allow you to wrap your pastes to fit your borders perfectly. It only takes a few minutes to show.
Now, when you install Microsoft Office Importer, you'll see this Axiom tab displays, and Microsoft Office Importer will be here on it. And so the purpose of Microsoft Office Importer is to copy Word or Excel information into Revit as linked data. And let me just get started straight in. I have this concrete summary here. I'm just going to select it all. There we go, and get it copied, and I'm going to switch back to Revit, and we hit the big paste button. And the first thing you want to do is pick origin point of paste, and that's always going to be the top left-hand corner. I'll start right there, and that gets in there right quick. And you'll notice there's a header here. I just want to point that out, and this is 5 rows high. And so we want to repeat those rows. You don't have to do that, but when you have something like this, where you've got a summary, sometimes you want to see the column headers in each column. So after that's done, I'm going to pick column height and gap width. And this is where I can define the bottom of my column and how far apart the column should be. So there you have it. Finished. Okay, so the next thing you want to do, let's say, well, what if, there's a change? Then what? Do I have to repaste it or what? And that is not the case. You can enter whatever you want here and save the changes and come back here. We have a manage link feature. And then you press the update button. And all done. You can now see changes have been made. It's as simple as that. And so now I'm just going to switch gears. By the way, this pastes as a schedule. So that's that. Let me close or delete that. And I'm going to switch and do something from Word as well. I've got a multi-page doc here. Just going to select that, copy it over. Same thing, going to press the paste button. Same thing again, pick origin point of paste. And here we go. And now we want to pick column height and gap width. We can make it a third if we wanted to. It kind of depends on how low you want to go. I'm just going to put it there. And we'll call that finished. And the thing I want to show you about Word is I want to demonstrate what happens when you add some rows and makes it too long for the columns you have. Well, then what? So we save that. All the way back, gonna manage link again. Press update. And there you go. It wraps to the next column. Or if this second column wasn't too long, it would just append it to the end of that. But the point is it maintains the integrity of the length of the columns as you defined it to begin with, which is exactly what you would hope for. All right, that's it for that. And the only other thing I would mention here is you do, what I did here was pretty much out of the box. So you do have a bunch of things where you can change your default fonts, change your borders, you can change the scales and some other things as well. You can pretty much handle or accommodate whatever pasting you need to do. But right out of the box, this thing works really well. And that is about it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.